Hi, I'm Eric with Great Western Building Systems. Thank you for joining us for the second video installment of our Building Erection Series. Today, we'll cover the anchor bolt verification as part of the pre-erection procedures. Most of this information will also help you lay out your foundation before you pour your concrete. In a future video, we'll go over foundations in more detail. Before you stand any columns or erect any parts of the building system, a handful of measurements need to be taken, just to make sure you don't need to make any corrections prior to setting the columns. Nothing's more aggravating than having to take steel down just to make a minor adjustment to a base plate or to add a shim here or there. These pre-erection measurement checks can all be done just after the foundation is poured and before the building arrives, so there's no reason to wait. Assuming your building is rectangular or square, start by verifying the squareness of the slab by measuring the two diagonals of the foundation. This is a corner-to-corner measurement that crosses the center of the building. If your building has skewed walls or is unusually shaped, our construction support folks will be able to help you by outlining some additional procedures if you'd like. All foundations vary in one way or another. This building will have a floating slab that will be poured after the building is erected. If your slab has been poured with the foundation, these procedures are still the same. Your tape measure should be long enough to measure all dimensions of the building in a single shot. A simple 100-foot reel works for most jobs. Start by pulling your tape from one corner diagonally to the opposite corner on the other end of the building and record that measurement. Then do the same for the other two corners as shown here. If these measurements are identical, we're off to a great start. There's a little tolerance allowed here, but it shouldn't be off by more than a quarter of an inch per 50 feet. If there's a larger discrepancy, our construction support staff will be able to provide some guidance. This is a good time to take a second and go over the sheeting notch. We typically design our buildings for a perimeter concrete wall with a 1.5-inch sheeting notch. Since an open wall, like a roof-only structure, doesn't have wall panels, a notch isn't necessary. While the sheeting notch is designed into the building plans, it's not a requirement. We like it because it provides extra weather tightness, helps prevent rodents from getting inside the building, promotes speed and ease of construction, and limits anchor bolt breakout by adding 1.5 inches of concrete between the edge of the foundation and the anchor bolts themselves. A sheeting notch may not be necessary, but it is recommended. If you are using a sheeting notch, remember that the foundation will be oversized by 3 inches in both width and length, or 1.5 inches on each wall. I'll go over the sheeting notch in more detail when we do our foundation video later. But right now, I bring it up because all the measurements should be taken from the top edge of the notch, which we call the steel line. After the diagonals have been measured, it's time to measure wall length. You will measure each wall of the building and verify measurements to each opposite wall and to the building plans as shown here. Now it's time for the more detailed work of checking the bolt placements and the elevations at the columns. In order to do this properly, you'll need your complete set of Great Western erection drawings, a tape measure, something to write with, and some scratch paper if you have it. First, verify the center lines of the I-beam columns and the web lines of the door jambs and other C-members. Here, we'll start with the back sidewall. From either end, measure from the top of the sheeting notch or steel line to the first I-beam column. For this building, the measurement should be 23 feet and 4 inches. This measurement should wind up in the exact center of the bolt pattern. Keeping the tape at the steel line, continue to the next column location. Here, we should have a measurement of 46 feet, 8 inches, which is the total of 23.4 plus 23.4. Your building may have a different base space, so keep in mind these measurements are only being used as an example. Follow the same procedures for the remaining walls. When measuring to a C-channel or a door jamb, you're measuring to the web of the column rather than the center line. Please note that the anchor bolt plan does not measure to the bolts. Bolt pattern dimensions and projections can be found on the next page, here and here. Now let's go ahead and check the bolt patterns themselves. Each column location will have a detail mark that references the detail on the following anchor bolt detail page. Here we're looking at detail C. Using your tape, check the bolts against the plan. For this building, the first set of bolts should be 12 1/4 inch from the steel line. You should be measuring to the center of the bolt and not to the edge. Then check the gap between the bolts, or what we call the gauge. Here, it should be 3 inches, or 1.5 inches from center line on either side. We typically use flush walls for the ends of the building, but this can sometimes apply to the sidewalls if you've requested a flush sidewall to save space. With a flush wall, the column flange will usually line up on the steel line, so the bolt will be much closer to the edge of the foundation. Looking at detail A, the center of the first bolt should only be 3 inches from the steel line, and the second bolt 7 inches. Tolerance for your anchor bolts is only 1/8 inch. Any more than that, reaming or slotting the base plate will probably be necessary. This is why it's so important to check and double check, and then recheck, and then check again to make sure these dimensions are correct prior to pouring the concrete. If you find that you're more than 1/8 inch out of tolerance, give us a call and we can go over the options and find the best solution for you. In cases where the bolts are more than 1 inch out of tolerance, you may find it easier to cut them flush and then drill and epoxy a new bolt, as shown here. Again, you should make a quick call over to our team so we can help guide you. Finally, use a transit or a laser to check the column elevations. On smaller buildings, some erectors will place the columns and the girts and then use a string line and a long level to check the column elevations. While experienced erectors may find this suitable, it really isn't the best way to level the building. I recommend using a transit, like the one here, over a laser level. Laser levels can be hard to read in the daylight, especially over long distances. If you don't have one, you should be able to rent a transit from your local home center. Start by plumbing your transit in the center of the building. Make sure you have a direct line of sight to each column location. Then, have a helper hold a grade rod, which is basically just a long yardstick or something similar, at each column location. Your helper should make sure that the grade rod is perfectly plumbed for the most accurate reading. Your transit should have a vertical line in the eyepiece for left to right plumbness. Record the measurement at each location. Keep in mind that the smaller the number recorded means the higher the pad of the column is. You'll want to take this into account if shimming is required. Tolerance can be a little more forgiving here, but if you can keep all columns within 1/8 inch, that's best. Lowering columns not easily done, so you should try to bring any low columns up with small shims, so long as you're not raising anything more than 1/2 inch or so. If more is required, give us a call and we can help you troubleshoot. Thank you for taking the time to check out this video, and I hope you find it useful. Even if your building isn't a Great Western, most of this information will apply to any pre-engineered metal building system. In our next installment, we'll begin erecting the steel columns, placing the girts, and setting the X-bracing. If you'd like to be notified of that and future videos of this series, please subscribe and click the notification bell below. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments section below, and I'll try to answer them personally. Thanks again, and build great. See you next time.